Hi, this is Darko. I'd like to give you a walkthrough of Shelley features with Daedalus 1.3.0 STN2 for the Shelley testnet. You can follow this walkthrough to experience the delegation mechanics and understand how the rewards work using testnet ADA before this becomes available on the Cardano mainnet later this summer. This new version of Daedalus enhances the delegation features with an improved ranking and rank calculation system based on the intended amount of delegated stake and added functionality for retiring stake pools. Also, rewards are now included in your wallet balance and spendable using regular ADA transactions. First, download the new 1.3.0 STN2 version of Daedalus from the testnet's Cardano.org website. You can find the installers in the Shelley section, here in the Getting Started menu on the Daedalus wallet for the Cardano Shelley testnet page. Download the installer for your operating system, launch it, and complete the installation steps. After installation completes, you will find the new Daedalus Shelley testnet V3 application installed. Launch it by clicking on the icon. Choose the language, number, date, and time formats you prefer, and click Continue to complete the initial setup. Scroll through and read the Terms of Service Agreement. Tick the box if you agree with it and click Continue. The splash screen is explaining the purpose of this version of Daedalus. Click the I Understand button to close it. You can always bring it back by clicking on this button with the Cardano logo and the name of the Cardano network we are connected to. Daedalus will quickly connect and synchronize with the blockchain in the background. Since this is the second iteration of the Shelley testnet network, your wallets from the first balance check iteration of the network will be empty here. So the first thing you need to do is create a new, empty wallet and fund it using the testnet faucet. Click the Create button to start the wallet creation process. Name your wallet and set a spending password. Click Create Shelley Wallet button to continue. This version of Daedalus works with the Shelley testnet and test ADA has no value. But I would like to take this opportunity to remind you that wallets can only be recovered using the wallet recovery phrase, so it needs to be kept safe and secure. The easiest way to keep it secure is by never storing it digitally or online. If you want to store it digitally, the best way to do that is by using one of the password manager applications that you know how to use and trust. Password managers are also recommended for generating and storing spending passwords. Click Continue and write down your wallet recovery phrase. When you are done, confirm that by clicking on the button. Click each of the words from your wallet recovery phrase in the correct order. Tick the boxes to confirm that you understand how to keep your wallet recovery phrase safe and to confirm that you understand that wallets can only be recovered using the wallet recovery phrase. And click Confirm. Your newly created wallet will quickly synchronize with the blockchain. This wallet is empty, so the first thing we need to do is to get some test ADA. You can copy a receiving address from your wallet receive screen. Go back to the Shelley testnet website and open the faucet from the Tools menu. Paste your receiving address in the form, tick the box to confirm that you are not a robot, and click the Request Funds button. The faucet will send some test ADA to your wallet. Let's go back to the wallet summary screen and wait for the test ADA to arrive. There, our wallet is now funded with test ADA and we can start testing the Shelley features. This icon under the wallet's icon in the sidebar, which depicts the decentralized network, takes us to the Shelley user interface. We have three tabs here: Delegation Center, Stake Pools, and Rewards. Here on the top of the Delegation Center, we can see the details of the current Cardano epoch on the Shelley testnet, and the countdown until the start of the next epoch. Epochs on the Cardano mainnet last 5 days, but here on the Shelley testnet, epochs are only 6 hours long to make testing quicker. In the wallet section, we can see our wallet and its delegation status, which is currently undelegated. The important thing to understand here is that changes to delegation preferences take effect after both the current and the next Cardano epochs have completed. This means that if we delegate our wallet now, that will take effect in about 6 hours, less than 1 hour remaining in the current epoch, plus the 6 hours needed for the next epoch to complete. Let's explore Stakepools before delegating our wallets. Here, we have a list of all available Stakepools on the Shelley testnet, which have completed all of the registration steps. A lot of Stakepools, represented by the small tiles, fit here on the screen. This is intentional. We made sure that we are not displaying only a couple of Stakepools on the first page, because those Stakepools would get almost all of the attention. For this reason, we don't get to show a lot of details about Stakepools before we open the details window. You can identify Stakepools using these ticker symbols, which are similar to ticker symbols for stocks on the stock market. The big, color-coded number is the pool rank. Pools with better ranking are green, and this gradually fades to orange, then red for Stakepools with the lowest ranking. The ranking system is much more sophisticated than the one used on the incentivized testnet. Before I explain the ranking feature, I have a disclaimer to state. This feature is intended for informational purposes only. You should always base your decisions on your own research and assessment of the Stakepools and the risks involved. The ranking is based on sophisticated game theory research that orders pools by the rewards that we should expect from delegating to them. Everything is taken into account: the cost of operating a pool and the profit margin set by the Stakepool operator, the performance of the pool, and the saturation, the amount of stake a pool has accumulated. The ranking system is promoting pools that are reliable, have not yet reached saturation, and have low cost and margin. This significantly simplifies making a good choice when delegating. We just need to choose one of the pools with high ranking. The rank is also based on the amount of stake we intend to delegate, because the rewards are kept for Stakepools when they reach saturation. This means that our saturated pools will earn the same rewards as if they were right around the saturation point, so they will earn fewer rewards per the amount of stake they control. And for this reason, they will drop in ranking. Here, on top of the screen, we have a slider for the amount of stake you intend to delegate. Alternatively, you can use this drop-down to select the amount of stake from one of your wallets, or the combined amount of stake from all of your wallets in case you have multiple wallets and you intend to delegate all of them to the same stake pool. This slider ranges from a minimum of 10 ADA to the saturation point for a single pool. Cardano protocol specifies the intended number of stake pools that will be producing the majority of the blocks. This number of pools is carefully decided on to balance the cost of operating the network, the desired level of decentralization, and the technical constraints of a global, decentralized network. The intended number of block-producing pools on the Shelley testnet is currently set to 250. With a total amount of stake in the network of 11 billion, we get to 44 million for the saturation point of a single pool. This is why 44 million is the maximum value for the slider, because delegating more than that would make even an empty pool oversaturated. At some point, the network will reach equilibrium after running for a certain number of epochs. When that happens, you just need to make sure you are delegating to one of the top 250 pools, because all of those pools should give you almost the same rewards. You just need to check from time to time and change your delegation choice in case the pool you are delegating to significantly falls in ranking. I would like to highlight that this number of stake pools is currently set to 250 for the Shelley testnet. It will be different on the Cardano mainnet, and it will change over time as the network grows and matures. The initial number will be decided on by the researchers and engineers, but later on, you and other ADA holders will be deciding on this number, and all other network parameters and changes, using the voting power which comes from owning stake in the system. Even though just the ranking is enough to make a good delegation choice, you can explore and see more details about each pool by clicking on these tiles. Notice that some pools have a red icon on their tile. These are pools that are retiring and will stop operating. You can see when the retirement will happen in the Stakepool details. Let's pick a pool and delegate our wallet. I will choose the top-ranked pool because I trust the ranking system. I can launch the delegation wizard by clicking on the Delegate to this pool button from the Stakepool details. The delegation wizard has three steps. Let's complete them. First, let's select our wallet. The pool is already selected since we've launched the delegation wizard from the stakepool details of this pool. Let's keep that choice and continue. Delegation choice needs to be posted on the blockchain. That's a transaction, so it requires paying fees. I will enter my spending password to sign the transaction and to confirm my delegation choice. There, my wallet is now delegated. It will take 6 hours for the delegation to take effect because the current and the next Cardano epochs need to complete. And 1 epoch later, I will get my first rewards. When that happens, I will be able to see the rewards I've earned here on the reward screen. So, that completes our walkthrough. I hope you enjoyed it and found the explanations useful. Download this version of Daedalus yourself and try it out. And please, give us your feedback and report any issues found. As always, use the help menu to submit a support request.